Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today in this video, I'm going to explain you about the different keys in DBMS. So let's get started. So what do we mean by a key and what is the need for keys? Let's create a table first. So let's say we have a table of students with the column names as name, age, and address. Now let's just quickly fill this out. Now let me explain you some basic terms that would be helpful for you to understand the keys concept. As you know, this complete thing is a column, and similarly this age, this address is a column, and these things, the name, age, and address, these are known as attributes. And these things, like this complete name Virat with age 36 and this Delhi, known as rows or tuples. So now, what do we mean by a key? So key is just an attribute. And what is the need for keys? So suppose we have a student name as Virat, and suppose here you can see we have two students with same name, same age, and same address. It can be possible, yes, we can have multiple students with same name, their age can be same, and their address can be same too. So now, how we can say that these two students are different students, although they have same name, age, and address? How we will say that these are two different persons? So now keys comes into picture. So keys are basically that attribute which uniquely identify between two tuples. So with the help of keys, we can distinguish between two different persons, irrespective of their name, age, and address are being same. So there must be some attribute that is different between these two persons or these two students. So what are those? So those can be roll number, registration number, their voter ID, license number, their email ID. So these attributes that are roll number, registration number, voter ID, license number, email ID, or there can be many more. So these attributes, these can be uniquely identified. This can be used to uniquely identify between two persons, and these attributes are known as our candidate key. And if I go with the definition of candidate key, it will be it is the attribute or the set of attributes that can uniquely identify between two tuples, and later on one of them will become a primary key that you will see. So here we have our candidate keys. Let's modify the tables and add our candidate key here. So let's add our candidate key here. So let's say we have roll number, then let's say we have voter ID and our license number, and let's suppose the student does not have voter ID, so he will leave it blank, and neither he have his license. And let's say all of the students does not have either the voter ID or the license, so all of them will leave that blank. So now there will still be an issue. It means we again encountered the same scenario. It means now also we cannot identify the two different persons we have with the same name, age and address, as these columns are left blank. So now the primary key comes into play. So the primary key is that attribute which can be used to uniquely identify between two tuples, and it cannot be left blank. It means it cannot be null. Let me write the definition first. So primary key is the unique identifier for two tuples, and it cannot be left blank or it cannot be null. It means here we had our candidate key like this 5, and in the definition of candidate key we have that attribute or set of attributes that will uniquely identify between two tuples, and one of them will become a primary key. So we have these three candidate keys like voter ID, license number and roll number. So one of them, that is the roll number, that cannot be left blank. It means the students cannot leave this part blank, and it is not like that they won't have the roll number, as the roll number is the must, and they should, and they must have the roll number. So the students cannot leave that blank. So let's say the roll number of the first student is, let's say 1 and 2 and 3. Now one can say that these three students are like a different students, although they have same name, age and address. So the primary key is basically, so the primary key is unique plus not null, and the candidate key is unique only, as it can be left blank or it can be null. So similarly, we have a roll number. We can also have a registration number as the primary key, as registration number also cannot be left blank. Now let us understand the foreign key. What do you mean by a foreign key? Let me write the definition of that as well. So what do you mean by a foreign key? So foreign key, with foreign keys we can link a column in one table with another table and establish a relationship between them. So let's see that also. So let's say we have one more table as course table. With the column as course name, and one more column as roll number. So it means we have one table, that is student table. So with the help of roll number, we can further find the course name in which the students are enrolled. So we have a roll number. We took the help of that roll number in one more table, that is the course table. And with the help of roll number, we can find the course name of the students. Let's say we have course as Java, SQL and React, and student with roll number 1 is enrolled to Java as well as SQL, and student with roll number 2 is enrolled to React. So with the help of this primary key, that is roll number, we took the help of this in another table, that is the course table, and with this we are able to find the course in which the students are enrolled. So this thing, here we have this primary key. So this primary key will be known as foreign key here. As it's taking the reference from another table, and the table which is taking the reference from another table is known as referencing table. It means this course table is taking the reference from another table. It will be called as referencing table. And the table from which the course table is taking the reference will be called as reference table. Now let's understand the last key, that is the super key. So let me write the definition of that first. So the super key is the combination of all possible attributes which will be helpful to uniquely identify between two tuples, and one of them must be a unique key. So let's create another table for this. So let's say we have the columns as name, again age, and roll number. So the super key is the combination of all possible attributes. So what are the attributes here? The name. So the name, age, and roll number. And one more combination. We can have more combinations like age, age and roll number. And then the third combination as name and roll number. And we can have one more combination as name and simply age. So as you can see, we have name, age, and roll number. And here we have one uniquely identifying key, that is the roll number. So this combination is known as our super key. Here also we have a combination of attributes like age and roll number, and here also we have one uniquely identifying key, that is roll number. So this is also our super key, and here also we have name and roll number, and again one uniquely identifying key, that is the roll number. It is also our super key. But here, as you can see, we have our combination of attributes that are name and age, but here we don't have any uniquely identifying key or attribute. So this is not our super key, and these three are our super key. Let's have a quick review. So candidate key are the attribute or set of attributes that can uniquely identify between two tuples, and one of them will become a primary key. So here we had roll number, registration number, voter ID, license number, email ID, or we can have more like Aadhaar card number, or maybe other things like our passport number. And one of them that cannot be left blank or cannot be null will become a primary key. Here in this case, our roll number become a primary key. And then we had our foreign key, as if we want to take a help of our primary key in another table to find more details about the student or any person, that thing, that primary key becomes a foreign key there in another table, and that table itself which is taking the reference known as a referencing table, and the table from which it took the reference known as the reference table. And at last we had a super key, that is the combination of all possible attributes. And here we have the combination of all possible attributes like name, age, roll number, but the condition is that one attribute must be uniquely identifying attribute, must be a unique key. So yes, that's it for this video. Hope you understood the concept of keys in a much better way. So see you all in the next one. Till then, take care.